Sometimes you go so far in your reading life that you end up all by yourself just reading the same books over and over, recombining them infinitely. But then one day a message arrives and you can't help it. You just go ahead and place the order. I couldn't help but notice this quote by John Gardner, where in his praise for this novel by Spanish author Juan Benet, he basically insults all of American fiction, which I found it a little bit odd given how difficult this book is. It's essentially one long paragraph with extremely long sentences. This is the kind of book that John Gardner, in his own book on writing, advises against. He even says at one point that it's hard enough being a novelist. It's even harder being a novelist that no one wants to read. This book falling within a certain sweet spot. We have his main influence, Faulkner here. Latin American writers throwing bombs all over the map, some of which are worth getting blown up by simply because of the power of the translator. In this case, Gregory Rabassa, who translated all three of these books and is able to work, you know, not only with the Gothic lacework of Lezama Lima, but also the cold, dead stone of Bennett. I was like, you know what? This is my bread and butter. So I dove right into it and just immediately regretted it, getting backslapped by this huge wall of text that slapped me around silly, left me even more broken and confused than before. Closest analog seems to be another disciple of Faulkner, who coincidentally also wrote about the Spanish Civil War and does a similar sort of mind mapping here, except where you can feel that this guy's currents are more dynamic. You got him circling and extrapolating upon its own creation. In Bennett, you feel like things are more carefully planned and architected, which makes sense given his day job as a civil engineer, dealing in his professional life with stubborn contractors and incompetent suppliers, and turning to writing at night as a way to counterbalance and maybe exert a more complete control over the creation. There's this design philosophy of creating better with another, but what if the partner doesn't exist anymore and only loneliness fuels creativity? Digestible. This book here showcasing play-by-play scenes of the Spanish Civil War in his, you know, signature top-down over-analytical style, where you got monologues that extend beyond belief and discourses in psychology and history and geography. We have sentences in a meditation that are somehow even longer, almost Proustian, except Proust has some built-in momentum in his romanticism and even some suspense, whereas in Bennett's case, it's almost like a suspension at best. At worst, it's like this infinite autopsy report. Ultimately, found it best to just scale it down and swallow a few words at a time and let understanding happen or not. It didn't really matter that, you know, you get certain characters confused with another, or that like you're reading this bone dry passage and it actually is like a lovemaking scene. If you just use it as a tool to just pass some time, in this way, you'll slip into this meditative state where the blueprint of the book starts to seep up subconsciously. These long sentences wrapping up these rooms like pearls or sore spots where you can't see the transitions anymore and it becomes this one smooth giant mess, but it's actually just a cross section of the book, the main action of which is the narrator crawling back and forth in time. You could deduce the author's personal pain and loss by what he passes over in silence. It's like past traumas coming off Earth as layers of energy still radiating out into outer space. You have the Holocaust, the Spanish Civil War, World War I. You got ancient battles and lost civilizations. Waves never stop repeating. You can't have pleasure without the pain. Thank you. fades in the morning light. Those sentences that you saw just crumble apart in your hands. But now you're inspired again to at least try, because after all, when we're gone, we'll only be these scratchings that we leave behind. Now you're flowing, hoping to catch the big fish and not be caught yourself. It's scary as hell, but also heavenly. Even if it amounts to nothing, and it most likely will, isn't the attempt still always worth it? Harlem Shake.